Hello, welcome to Tiny Ekiti YouTube channel. If you are new here, kindly take a minute to subscribe and click the bell icon so you can get a notification once a new video or tutorial is uploaded. In this video, I'll be your facilitator as we will learn how to fully install AEproject on Ubuntu operating system. If you're a Windows user, kindly check out our video installing AEproject on Windows. If you are new to Ekiti channel and you are wondering what I mean by AEproject, kindly check out our video explaining AEproject using the link I will display on the screen. So, for easy access, I've created a document that contains all the links you need to install AEproject, and I'll be sharing this link as a description under the video. So, let me get the link. And then we get started with the installation. So this is the link, the guide link. And as I've said earlier, this document will be available as a description under this video. So for the introduction video, you need to go through this link. To get started with the installation, we'll make use of the official webpage of AEproject. So, to have a working installed Ubuntu on your device, you have to get some things installed. So, let's first go to the official page, which is here. So, I'm going to close this introduction video link. And as you can see, this is the official page for AEproject, and where we all this has been explained in the introduction video. So we're just going to go to quick start and get started. So to have a working AEproject installed on your Ubuntu device, you have to get some things installed on your system first, if they are not already installed. The first is Node.js, at least version 9.5.0. The second is Python. Why the last and most important is Docker, with Docker Compose, with a list version of version 1.20.0. Note, I have a perfectly working AEproject package on my device, which I had to download and install all that is required. So we have a perfect uninterrupted video due to internet connectivity. Don't worry, I will use these guide links when installing and would explain in details how to get AEproject installed on your device as well. So let's get started. The first thing we have to do is to install Node.js alongside its package manager. To do that, I'll get the link from our guide and open on Chrome. So this is it, Node.js, how to install Node.js on Ubuntu 20.0. If you make use of any version lesser than 20.0.04, don't worry, you can always change the version at this point. So I'm going to use version 20.0 to explain this. All right, in this video, we'll use three different, as you can see in this guide, we'll show you three different ways of getting Node.js installed on Ubuntu 20.0. The first is using ækiti. And the ækiti software repository, then installing NVM. This was what I used. I used the option one, and it's very okay. And you can also use that, because I guarantee that works well. So to do that, all you need to do is to update your package manager using this command, sudo ækiti update. Then once you do that, you install Node.js using that same ækiti install command, this. And the next is going to be this, to check out your version. So for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to check my version, my Node.js version also. And to do that, I'm going to type Node.js that's real. So as you can see, I have version 10.90 installed, and all I did was just to follow this simple step. First, to update my apt package manager, then I installed Node.js, then you can check your version. We are not done yet. Now we have to install the package manager for Node.js, and you can easily do that also using this sudo command, sudo apt install npm. Now, once you have this, you have npm and can now run npm commands on your Ubuntu system. If you have done this before, you don't need to do this step, as you can move on to the next step. So the next thing we're going to do now before installing Python is to run our npm commands without sudo. So to do that also, I have a link at the guide links that will show you how to run npm command without sudo. So this here, it's gonna come here and open that. So let me close this. Okay. Great. So avoid using sudo. The first thing you need to do, which was what I also did on my Ubuntu device, was to run this command, which means I want to make a directory called .npm packages. Then after that, I ran this command that setting my npm config to my created folder. After that, all you need to do is to add this to your path. And before you do that, you need to run this nano bash rc dot rc. Then you add this test npm store, the directory of the folder we created. Then export the path by adding this to the path. Then you have to, you also have to export this man path to have a successful working npm package without sudo. So as you can see, just let me get that. I can now run npm package as well without sudo. So I'm just going to say npm. As you can see, I have the help here where it says how to use npm commands. So cool. So I'm just going to clear my terminal around. And then we move to the next thing. So now let's move to the installation of Python. If you have Ubuntu 20.04 version installed on your device, you should have Python installed automatically. You can check the version of your installed Python using a command which is Python 3 version, then the flag of version. So I'm just going to go there. Okay, cool. We have Python 3-V. So as you can see, I have Python 3.8.2 installed on my device. And if you don't have this version, then you'd have to follow this procedure. So to follow that procedure, what you need to do again is to go to the guide link right here and just click here and yeah. So if you have any version less than Ubuntu 20.04, you can choose your version here as well for installing Python. So as you can see, with your server setup, you already begin. So we have to use sudo also here to install Python. And if you're on Ubuntu, as I said earlier, you should have Python installed. But if not, just run this command, sudo apt update first. Once you update that, then you run this sudo apt flag y upgrade. Once you do that, it should upgrade your package too. And once you've done that, you can now run this Python 3 version V to get this output. So once you have that installed as well, you are good to go. So, don't worry, we're getting closer. And now let get to the most important tool, which we need to install on our device. I'm sure we know by now that Docker and Docker Compose are the most important tool needed to have a fully functional AEproject package. So let's first start with installing and configuring Docker. To do this, I also get the link from our guide, which is this, installing Docker on Ubuntu. So great. Now this is the link. Now we're making use of Ubuntu, which as you can see, if you want to install Docker engine on Ubuntu, your OS operating system must either be Ubuntu Focal 20.04 or the other ones. So since this tutorial video is for installing, definitely we don't have an older version, so we don't need to run this command. Then you can install Ubuntu in different ways, which most users set up their Docker repositories and install from them for easy installation and upgrade tasks. This is the recommended approach, which was what I did on my device as well. So that is what we're going to make use of. And I would say you just look things well here, because it's tricky from here. So the first thing we have to do is to update our apt package 2 again using this sudo command. Then the next thing we want to do is to copy everything from here to here after running this command. Once we copy this, we paste this also in our terminal. So just so you can see, I have this installed. I'm going to open my terminal as well and paste this. Now that I've done this, you need to input your password, because you're using the sudo command. As you can see, it said it's already in the latest version. The following package automatically installed and are no longer required. So this is just showing you that I have all these packages, all these packages installed on my device. So I'm just going to clear my terminal and then move to the next thing. So the thing you have to do now is to add a Docker official GPG key. And to do that, all you need to do is to copy this link. And since you have crawl installed already from here, all you just do is to get this. Once you have this, you also add it to your terminal and you're good to go. Then the next thing you would want to do is to run this command as well, which is the sudo apt key fingerprint this value. And once you do that, you should get this response. Great. Now we're ready to install Docker engine. So the first thing we're going to do after all this, after we've added our key and we've checked our fingerprint, is to run this command, which is actually creating a package repository for your Docker in case of upgrade later in the future and easy access to either uninstall, upgrade your Docker. So the first thing we have to do is to run this command, is to do apt repository from here. From here. Cool. After that, we then need to update our package tool again using this command. Once we've done that, we can now install Docker engine using this command. Now that we've installed Docker engine using that command, you are good to go, and we have Docker engine installed already. So you don't need to go through anything from here. All you need is just from here upwards, and you have Docker installed on your device successfully. So cool. As you can see, now we have Docker installed. The next thing we need to do is to set our Docker commands to execute without the sudo as well. So to do that also, I have a link on the guide that would help you do just that. So join. I want to close this and then open this. Great. So now we want to be able to run Docker commands without the sudo. The first thing we want to do is to create a group called Docker. So you run this command sudo group add Docker. And the next thing we want to do is to add the user, add your user, your recent Ubuntu user to the Docker group using this command. Once you have that, you would want to run this new group Docker. And once you have that, once you do this, you can now run Docker commands without sudo. So if you want to test that, you can use this Docker run hello world, which you download an hello world container on your machine. But to test your Docker installation, you can do that using Docker. Great. As you can see, I have Docker version 19.0311 build in this value. So you can also test your Docker command without sudo using that command. So cool. Now, great. We're now fully ready to install the AEproject. But before then, we need to install a last important tool, which is the Docker Compose. So to install Docker Compose, as I said, the installation guide link provides you with everything you need to install Docker. And to get that, all you need to do is to click on this link. I want to close this. Great. So now we are in the process of installing Docker Compose, which is the last tool you will need to install Docker. So prerequisite, we have this Docker Compose is included in part of desktop installer. So before you can install Docker Compose, you must have Docker engine installed. To run Compose as a non-node, you have to do this, which we've done. So we've passed this stage, and then we can move to the next stage. So since we are using Ubuntu, we won't be using this. We'll be using this command. So the first thing we want to run is this command sudo crawl. Then everything here. Don't worry. Since you've downloaded this command, this package earlier, when you wanted to install Docker, you won't have any problem running this command. So once you do this, which we download and the current Docker Compose, then we need to install, if you want something else, which you don't need. All you have to do is to make use of this latest version. If you want to install a lesser version of Docker Compose, which I don't advise. So once you pick this, you're good to go. Then you have to apply this. You have to apply executing permission to the library, which you can do just running this command. Cool. Now, if you have any issue running this command, then you have to check this command instead. But once you run this one, you should be good to go. Then the next thing you need to do is check for your Docker version, your Docker Compose version, and you can easily do that using this or using Docker Compose which would also show you your Docker version. So as you can see, I have Docker installed, I have Node.js installed, I have Python installed, and you can also have all those installed using this links and this guide I explained in this video. So now that we have AEproject installed, we have all the tools necessary installed. The next thing we want to do now is to install the famous AEproject with its npm package. So if we go back through our official AEproject website, after we've done this requirement, we can see that to install AEproject itself, we have to make use of this npm package, which is really cool. Npm install -g, this flag is to install AEproject globally, then AEproject. So what you want to do is just to copy this and then paste it on your terminal. I won't be doing that because I have it installed and I won't want to mess up my configuration. So once you do that, you have AEproject installed and you can now run AEproject command. As you can see, I will just test this using this. So I'm just going to say AEproject. Great. Now I have AEproject installed. So now that we all have AEproject installed on our device, which means you can now write, compile, test, and deploy Sophia Smart Contract from your device, which also comes along with the ability for you to build amazing apps with either Vue, React, or Angular front-end framework. That's how awesome AEproject is. So since we have all these tools installed, I would advise, which is very, very essential, for you to restart your device so as to complete the installation process. Because you having all these tools installed needs to change some things in your environment and some other stuff. So it's advisable for you to restart your system. And once you've done that, you can now build on AEproject. So I'm going to wait for you to restart your system, then we'll move on. So great. Now let's perform some magic by executing some AEproject commands. So I'm going to run this command and also run this command. So once I do that, don't worry, that won't be all, because we have a tutorial video that's going to show you how to build a to-do list app using AEproject shape technology. So and that video would show you how to make use of AEproject commands better than this. So the first thing I want to do is to go to my terminal. Let me clear this. Then after that, let me cd into documents. Okay, now I'm going to make a directory called AEproject test. I'm just going to do this. Yeah, cool. Great. Now I love using my VS Code to run my AEproject commands. That's just me. You can run your AEproject command here as well. So I'm going to open my VS Code on my AEproject test directory. So I'm just going to say AEproject test. Okay, great. All right, cool. Now I have my VS Code up and running. So I'm going to make use of my VS Code terminal to actually initialize this directory with AEproject using the AEproject init command. So this would download AEproject packages, including some development scripts, some contract file, and a lot of other amazing stuff, including the Docker configuration for you to be able to run AEproject locally. So while we're waiting for this, I'm going to go over the guide link again. So this link is for the official AEproject webpage. Why this link is to introduce you to AEproject if you don't know about it. Right, this link is for you to install Node.js on your Ubuntu device, as well as npm package manager, which is the Node.js package manager. then this Node.js extra link is for you to be able to run Node.js commands without sudo. Then the next link here is how to install Python on your Ubuntu device. Then the next one is installing Docker engine on Ubuntu, which follows by Docker extra of setting your Docker commands to run without the sudo command as well. Then the last link here is the Docker Compose link, which shows you how to install Docker Compose. So let's go back to this. Cool. Now we have AEproject installed on this directory. And as you can see, we have a folder here with an example contract, which is an crypto master contract. Inside that, inside another folder is the deployment script. Then, which the important part, the Docker, including the configuration. Then we have this, we have our node modules, and we have our test, which is really important. So I'm going to run a command called AEproject env. So this command actually makes you run your local nodes, including your compiler on Docker. Don't worry, most of these commands will be explained in the to-do list tutorial. So just let me run this command. So while building our local node, this command will also give us 10 different wallets with its private key and public key, and also fund those wallets. So we have this error. So I'm gonna clear this first and then run this command AEproject env, which is a short for AEproject environment. Okay, we have this up to date now. Okay, I guess that was because of my internet. Yeah, so the command, the error it gave me earlier was due to internet. Now that my connection is better, you can see our node was successfully started, our compiler was successfully started, and now it's finding our default wallet, which is this. And it's going to give you 10 different wallets with its public key and its private key, and then credit those wallets for you so you can do your unit testing. And I'm just going to stop this tutorial here. Because if I want to get in now, I would just go in more and more and more. So anticipate our video, check out the video explaining how to build a to-do list app using AEproject. By the way, I'm Ekiti Lead and Ambassador with Emmanuel Joseph Jett as my name, and you can always contact me via my contact on our website, which is aekiti.com. If you have any issue installing AEproject on your Ubuntu device, feel free to send a DM or add a comment to this video. Thanks, and if you haven't subscribed to our channel, kindly do that now. Like, you won't want to miss more amazing videos. So, with this, bye for now, and see you in the next video.